Hi, it's Lewis here from the Vevox Customer Success Team. I'm here with another video, and this time we're going to be talking about our Office 365 PowerPoint add-in for Windows and Mac users. So with this add-in, we need to use our dashboard to start with. So for all new users of Vevox or existing users of Vevox, we're going to be doing everything that we would normally do when running a session using PresentView. However, this time we're going to incorporate it all into PowerPoint afterwards. So as normal, we would go in and we'd create a Vevox session. I've created mine. And then we'd create a few polls here in the dashboard. Once we're done, we can then incorporate that into our slides. So let's go over to Vevox in PowerPoint. So here's my PowerPoint deck. I'm going to add some slides in a second. But first of all, I want to install the add-in. Now, I've already got it installed on my machine. But to get it, it's actually now really simple. You go over to Get Add-ins and then go into the store. And then once the store loads, you search for Vevox, and it should appear here in the store. Now, if it doesn't appear, it might be that your IT team need to allow the add-in to be visible. If you need any help with that, contact us at support@vevox.com. Once it's there in your store, you press Add, and then it appears on your home part of the ribbon here at the top. Once we click on it, we then have the task pane here that appears on the right-hand side, and I'm already connected and logged in to the add-in. The login procedure is exactly the same as logging in online. I'm just skipping that step for this video. At the top here, you can see we've got the instructions about what to do. So we've got click add-in to insert a poll. Each poll creates two slides, as you'll see in a moment. You can present your slideshow as normal, and the polls will automatically open when you reach that slide in your presentation. So first of all, we're going to add our joining instructions. So we've got all of the detail on screen for people needed to join the session. And then we're going to add a couple of polls. So we're going to add two polls. And you can see that our polls are now on two slides each. That's purely because we want to make sure that the results are dynamic, so they update in real time. And we want to make sure that the polls are showing the correct results afterwards. So treat these polls as pairs. So we want to make sure that the slides are pairs. If you move them around in the deck, then you need to make sure that you move them together. If you end up with a slide slotting in between like this, it means that the poll won't work properly. So if you do move them around, make sure you move them in pairs and treat them as pairs. All that's left is to run our slides. So let's jump straight into slideshow mode. We can navigate through our slides as normal using our mouse or a slide changer or the spacebar, or whatever we're comfortable with. We've got our instruction slides here so people can join. And then when we get to our first slide, the poll is now open. We can see that we've got one person connected, which is me on my phone. And we can see that the poll is both open and those X's have now been filled in with the session ID. So I'm going to put in my favorite color. You can see that's updating in real time. So if I clear my response and change it to green, as with PresentView, it's updating in real time. So once I'm happy enough to confirm my results, I can click my mouse or press the space bar and I can move on. And it's now going to prepare the results and then show the results on the results slide. And that's also mirrored across on my phone. And we'll just try that one more time with a pin on image poll. So this one is, where is Los Angeles? Now there is a correct answer associated with this. So I need to tap on the screen and press send. Now I've not got my pin quite right, but you can see here that my pin has landed on Los Angeles. So I can always change it and I can click somewhere else on the map. And the minute I press send, my dot will move and now it's there in Colorado. But I want to put it back on Los Angeles and press send. And there's roughly where LA is. Click my mouse and then the poll closes and we can see that that dot was what I permitted to be my correct answer location. So I did just about make it by the skin of my teeth. And there we have the results on the screen. We click on, and that's the end of our slide deck. And actually, that's the end of this short video. If you have any questions, please do get in touch with us at support@vevox.com. But all that's left for me to say is thank you very much for watching this video, and I'll catch you on the next one.